Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this question, we have been given this transistor circuit, and in this circuit, the BJT is used as an amplifier. So we have been asked to find the voltage gain of the given amplifier circuit. Now to find the voltage gain, first of all, we need to find the small signal equivalent circuit of the given amplifier. And for that, we need to replace this BJT by the small signal model. Now, if you see this small signal model, then first of all, we need to find the value of this transconductance. And this transconductance GM can be given as this collector current divided by the thermal voltage. Now here, we have been already given the value of the thermal voltage. That is the KT by Q is equal to 26 millivolt. But here, we need to find the value of the collector current. So to find the collector current, first of all, we need to do the DC analysis. So for the DC analysis, all these capacitors will act as an open circuit and all the AC signals can be assumed as a zero. That means for the DC analysis, if we see the equivalent circuit, then it will look like this. So now for this given circuit, let us find the collector current. Now here we have been given that the base current is negligible. Or indirectly, we can say that the value of beta is very high. That means here, this collector current IC is approximately equal to emitter current. So first of all, let us find the value of this emitter current. And for that, let us apply the KVL equation in this loop. So if we apply the KVL equation, then we can write 0 volt minus VBE minus VE minus of minus 10 volt is equal to 0. Now here we have been given that the value of VBE is equal to 0.7 volt. That means we can say that this emitter voltage VE is equal to 10 volt minus 0.7 volt. And this emitter voltage is equal to IE times RE. That means IE times RE is equal to 9.3 volt. Or we can say that this emitter current is equal to 9.3 volt divided by 20 kilo ohm. That is equal to 0.465 milliampere. So roughly we can say that this collector current IC is equal to 0.465 milliampere. That means we can say that this transconductance GM is equal to IC divided by VT. That is equal to 0.465 divided by 26 millivolt. So that is the value of the transconductance. So once we know the value of this transconductance, then let us do the AC analysis of the given circuit and let us find the value of the voltage gain. So for the small signal analysis, if we see the equivalent circuit, then it will look like this. That means here, this coupling and the bypass capacitors will act as a short circuit, while these DC voltage sources will also act as a short circuit. Now here, as this bypass capacitor gets short circuited, so effectively we can say that this emitter terminal is also get short circuited. That means now, this input voltage is connected between the base and the emitter, while this collector resistor is connected between the collector and the emitter terminal. And we can replace this transistor by the small signal model. So now if we see the AC equivalent circuit, then it will look like this. That means the input voltage is connected between the base and the emitter terminal, while this collector resistor is connected between the collector and the emitter terminal. So now for the given circuit, the Vout can be given as minus IC times RC parallel RL, where IC is equal to GM times Vπ. And if you see over here, then this input voltage Vin is equal to Vπ. That means we can say that this Vout is equal to minus GM times Vin times RC parallel RL. Or we can say that the Vout divided by Vin is equal to minus GM times RC parallel RL. Now here, the value of RC and the RL are 10 kilo ohm. That means V out by V in is equal to minus of 0.465 divided by 26 millivolt times 10 kilo ohm in parallel with 10 kilo ohm. That is equal to minus 0.465 divided by 26 times 5000. And if we calculate the value, then the voltage gain will come out as minus 89.42. That means we can say that for the given amplifier circuit, the voltage gain V out divided by V in is equal to minus 89. That means for the given question, D is the correct answer.